Hi, welcome to another video from Automex Tools. We have a new device today for the TPMS and the TPMS sensors. If you are having problems regarding the customers coming up with their cars for their TPMS light turn on their instrument cluster, or whenever you replace tires from them or make any service related to tires, and after putting back the tires, there is TPMS light turned on. Today I'm going to show you a device with MX sensors that can help you resolve these kind of problems, right? The device here, the ITS600, helps you check the sensors if there is a problem with the sensors or relearn them according to the placement of the tires. The OBD device here helps this device to communicate with the ECU for the TPMS and help relearn you with any car for any brand, whether it be German, American or Asian brand. Mostly customers having problem with their TPMS sensors because the usual TPMS sensors have a battery life of around 7 to 8 years. After the battery is having a problem, you can just replace it with the MX sensor that is compatible with almost 99% of the vehicles for 433 megahertz or 315 megahertz. These sensors here come in two types. This is the metal valve type and the rubber type. The sensor is easily clampable. It comes with this clamp-on sensors, okay? Easily to install, and you can program it with the new ITS600 using the OBD connector. You can take the IDs from the ECU and program each sensor one by one, whether you require one sensor or all of the four sensors for your customer's car. You can program them one by one. Let me tell you some simple steps how to program the MX sensor using the ITS600. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to program an MX sensor using the ITS600. Okay, first of all, very important, you need to know the frequency that your car that you are working on is working. There are two kinds of frequencies, 315 and 433. You check this one. We need to use the key of the car because the key for the car and the TPMS uses the same frequency for a specific car. So we'll go to RKE and RF and click any button, lock or unlock, and it will show you the frequency for the car. Now we know that this car specific one is working for the 433 megahertz. Now we're gonna go to TPMS menu. If a car is for 433 megahertz, always use market as Europe. If a car is 315 megahertz or belongs to American specs, use 315 megahertz. If a car belongs to 433 megahertz frequency, we will use the Europe market. If a car has 315 megahertz of frequency or North American market, we will use here. For this specific one, we will use the Europe market. Then select Toyota. The manufacturer year of the car and click OK. Now this is the screen there. Here we can check the existing sensors of the car, make diagnostic with the ECU for the TPMS, make programming and relay. To check the existing sensors of the car, we will use the check function. This system has been elaborated in the demo in the link that is provided in the description. Here I'll just show you how to program an MX sensor using the ITS600. Procedure for programming metal sensor and the rubber sensor is same. We'll go to the programming menu. If you are taking the sensor IDs from the ECU, all the sensor IDs will be available here. If you do not have sensor ID stored in the ECU, you can use the auto create option. Okay, and it will create up to 16 unique IDs for your car. If you need only one, just place one sensor and click OK. After that, the ITS600 will detect how many sensors are near that device, and it will provide a unique sensor ID. Now here, as you can see, it says 8 sensors are detected. Make sure that whenever you are programming, only one sensor should be near the ITS600. Once it has detected the sensor, just click OK.
and the programming procedure has started. Once the programming has been completed, just what you have to do is install this sensor into the rim, inflate the tire, and you can program this sensor using the check method.
Hope you like our video. There is another demo for the ITS 600. The link is in the description below. Still, if you have any question, just WhatsApp us on this number or just leave a comment below and we'll be happy to respond to your queries. Thank you.